very flexible and anything. The volunteers search tirelessly for bargain sleepers, fish plates and rails.
Don't be stupid. I'm on video.
The volunteers started their first train service at the But there was a slightly serious concern. None of the volunteers had a background of working on the railway. A bit of good luck arrived in the society's hour of need.
Just across the road from Bitten, there were a number of railway cottages that were built for the people who built the railway. And one of the old gangers, who was about his 80s then, still lived there. And he actually was one of the people who maintained this section of track. So he came over and gave us some advice on track laying and showed us the techniques. And the people around here from him.
I got quite involved with the track initially. I used to put a theory out, are you weightlifting and would you like to get fit for weightlifting without going to the gym? And that was, got some people calm into working on the track.
Although track playing started in 1973, it took several years to lay even a few hundred yards of track.
By 1974, the first section of track, long enough to...
quite proud, really, that we'd achieved that.
In 1972, the railway's first steam locomotive... The locomotive was delivered in time for the Easter 1974 steam-up event. With the station building almost complete, and 2,000 connecting points, the Bristol Suburban Railway Society was ready to operate their first steam train for fare-paying passengers over the 13th and 14th of April. The 1918-built Avonside 060 saddle tank with a brakeman, landing on the cattle dock, where the new book is located, is just past the goods shed.
And it was
in the early days of driving the engine, it was almost a case of, well, read the book, then once somebody knows how to do it, you go and do it.
In spite of the limitations, the public response to the steamer open weekend was tremendous. But when word got back to the British Rail that the Bristol Suburban Railway Society was actually operating trains, the society was not only banned indefinitely from operating trains, but also from displaying static steam locos and even holding open days. Nevertheless, the society needed to bring in funds to continue with their rebuilding plans.
They would collect those paper, they would basically do anything to generate funds to build the railway.
We were collecting those paper, raffles, we did sponsored rides, walked along the line, so you know, did we get anything that we could to put the money coming in?
Taking the change of the the start.